Now in this video I'm going to go through some of the different line weights and lengths that you can use with the Revolution, as well as some of the reasons that you might select one over the other in different wind conditions, on different kites, or depending on what you're trying to elicit from the kite. It's sort of a free-form subject, so I'm just going to do my best to go through the very basics, and then we'll talk about the theory a little bit as we get into it. First, the basic line weights that we're using are 50 pound, 90 pound, and 150 pound. Doesn't really matter which brand you're using, as long as it's high quality. The lengths, or rather the weights, are usually fairly comparable. But just for a point of example, we'll talk about the three that I'm using. Here in this photo, you can see the 50 pound, the 90 pound, and the 150 pound side by side. You can see the 50 pound is quite thin. It almost looks like dental floss, as compared to the 150, which is really stiff, and it'll almost stand up on its own, particularly when it's new. As far as choosing between the three different weights, 50 pound is really, really superb for absolute light wind or zero wind conditions. The two main reasons for that is that the line itself is quite light, so there's not much weight against the kite draping between you and the handles, so the kite can really fly fairly unrestrained. The other factor as well is that the 50 pound is quite thin, and that represents less wind drag as the kite's traveling through the sky. So both the weight and the drag do have an influence on the kite while you're flying. And I think the simplest description of how the 50 pound feels is that the connection between you and the kite is very direct, because the lines are so light that they're just held straight, taut between you and the kite. So really you get a feeling of more immediate response. The trade-off to it is that because of the lower strand count and the lower strength of the line, the 50 pound tends to have a little bit of a sponginess. Not while you're flying so much, as much as when you're doing axles or flick-flacks or hard turns, anything where you're really snapping the end of the line. The way that I could describe it is that there's just a little bit of a give at the critical moment. It's overcomable, and in the very lightest winds, I think that the trade-off is well worth it. So if you don't have a set of 50 pound line in your bag or equivalent thereof, I definitely recommend you get some if you find that you're in light wind conditions more often than not. The 90 pound, now 90 pound is like the mana line. It's good for really just about any kind of wind condition. You know, with a little bit of technique, I could use 90 pound, I think, all the time, all the way down to 0 to 2 miles an hour, where I'm definitely working my tail off, on up to probably about 20 miles an hour. It's thick enough to sustain some minor impacts when you're team flying. It's strong enough that you're not liable to break it, because the weight is really suspended on four lines, the top lines more so, of course, but on all four lines. So it's not as susceptible to breakage, I think, as you'll find the same line weight on a dual line would be. Stepping on up to the 150 pound. Now, 150 pound is probably the most rarely used line weight that we have in our bag on iQuad. However, I'm here to tell you, when the wind gets over, say, 20 miles an hour or so, the kites really start to accelerate quite a bit, and they start to feel a little bit unruly, as to say that when you make an input, they'll really jump and leap and accelerate into that turn. So that's the point, especially when we're flying team, that we would go to 150 pound line. It's sort of like putting ankle weights on your kite, I think is the best way to describe it. We don't really switch to it for the strength necessarily, as much as the additional line drag and sort of mutedness or oppression that it puts on the speed and the power of the kite. So, you know, just using a vented 4-wrap, 1.5 for example, going from 90 pound, where that kite's tweaking and jumping, and just changing the lines to 150 pound will significantly improve the handling of the kite and make it so it's a little bit less jumpy. So again, a very rarely used line weight, but a very useful tool to have in your arsenal if you're finding that you're in a wide range of conditions from time to time. So having covered the line weights, the lengths are, there's a little bit more variable in how we look at that. Let's start at the very shortest. You know, usually I think the shortest that I'm using outdoor is probably about 30 foot. It's what I often refer to as my street lines. It's 30 to 35 feet of 50 pound, because again, I'm usually in very, very light and variable wind conditions. But the control aspects and the flying aspects that I'm about to describe will translate even if you're using 90 pound short lines or 150 pound short lines. the main thing with the short lines, regardless of what weight you're on, is that it's sort of like the same thing the 50 pound does. It gives you an immediacy of connection with the kite, because there's practically no line between you and the kite. There's almost no drape, almost no wind drag. So when you say go, the kite really loads up and moves quite quickly. The trade-off to that, however, is that because the lines are so short, your wind window, the space in which you have to fly, is really, really reduced. Okay, so here's just an example. Short lines, you can fly this range. Medium lines, you can fly this range. And then long lines, you have a much larger wind window. And we'll talk about wind window and some of the dynamics that are involved in that, possibly in another tutorial. But again, for the purpose of line length, the trade-off in a nutshell with short lines is that you don't have as much space, so you have to know where you're going, or you have to have enough wind where you're able to hover with some measure of consistency. Again, though, the directness of attention and that feeling of additional control that you get on the kite is certainly worth checking out. Stepping on up, I think the next average line length that you'll see in people's bags is anywhere from 75 to 85 feet, somewhere in that range. That's quite often the standard length that was sold by Revolution, and still is on some days. Basically, again, going to a medium length, we're just cover the two dynamics again. You have a little bit more line, so there's a little bit more drape and a little bit more wind resistance on the line itself. If you have enough wind to power that kite and drive it, it's really not a concern at all. In lighter winds, you'll start to feel that come into play a little bit. The other dynamic again, of course, is the wind window. Going to medium lines, you've now expanded the space you've had, right? And now you trade off a little bit on the amount of line tension that you actually have in the kite. So what we're sort of doing is leaning between the two extremes. So again, short lines, direct tension; long lines, larger window. So you're basically, again, just measuring the scale based on what you actually want to elicit from the kite. So the line length we just talked about, 75 to 85 feet, that's sort of, I think it's sort of an all-purpose range. It's kind of nice because you can fit into a lot of flying areas, and it's generally reserved for individual bag. And so saying that, the next usual step up is 120 feet. That's a pretty significant jump, but the reason that 120 feet are so commonplace now is that teams use them as the international standard. Wherever you go in the world, if teams are plugged into the general community and frequently meet up with one another for mega flies, you're going to see almost all of them on the same length within a tolerance of several feet. And so having the same line length is really ideal for team flying. In some of our future team tutorials, which I hope to be doing, we'll talk a little bit about draft and how one kite closer to you affects it than another. But again, talking about line lengths, 120 foot being the universal team standard, great to have in your bag, because wherever you meet up with any other flyer anywhere in the world, chances are you can just get up in the air and hover, hang out with them, bump into them, whatever it is, all the way up to team flying, which I'm here to tell you also is much easier than it looks. So 120 foot, you have this enormous window. That's the reason we choose it for team, because with more kites in the sky, you need more space and more room to maneuver. So that pretty much talks about the basic dynamics in the line weight and the line length. I encourage you to experiment with all of them if you have access to do so. You know, you can always chop up old lines that you don't use anymore, play around with shorter lengths. Really, at the end of the day, for me, in my philosophy, I believe that trying every possible variation that you can that is the least bit interesting is only going to enrich your own experience, give more muscle memory for yourself, having experienced a wide range of personalities from the kite based on the equipment you chose. And you know, just try it all, have fun, and be sure and jump on the Revolution Kites forum, revkites.com/forum. There is a ton of information there, and folks are always interested to hear about your experiences, especially for the better or the worse. Very friendly community. So thank you very much, and we'll see you in the next tutorial.